So I'm sure everyone here knows about the war going on between Russia and Ukraine. Now, here, I have a blank map of the world, and I'd like you to raise your hand if you're 100% confident that you can find Ukraine on this map. Okay, not bad. If you can't, don't worry, because you're not alone. Only 1 in 3 American voters can. Now, you're probably thinking, okay, we're not directly involved in this war, so what's the big deal with not knowing where Ukraine is? Well, the numbers have shown that even in countries in which we've had active military involvement, we still had trouble locating them. In 2002, at the beginning of the US conflict in Afghanistan, only 17% of young Americans could find it on a map. What does this mean? What does it mean when we, as citizens of the most powerful country in the world, cannot identify where major global conflicts are taking place, including those in which we're actively involved in? Here's what it means. When we don't know where Ukraine or Afghanistan is, we lack the key geographic knowledge needed to make informed decisions. So let me illustrate this. A look at a map tells us that Afghanistan lies at this crossroads between Central, South, and West Asia, which means that it has always been at the middle of conflicts between the great powers of the continent. And knowing about its mountainous terrain gives us insight into the politically fragmented nature of the country. Afghanistan's terrain has actually culturally divided the country, which means that ethnic groups like the Pashtun, the largest in the country, are actually made up of many smaller tribes and groups and people of differing cultural values. And in an attempt to work with the Pashtun to establish order in Afghanistan, the US treated them as a singular monolith. But this didn't really work. In addition to this, the mountainous terrain is never advantageous to the attacker, and this definitely contributed to the length and costliness of the US involvement in Afghanistan. Now, let's go back to Ukraine. Voters that know where Ukraine is are more likely to understand its strategic location on the Black Sea as a buffer between Central Europe and Russia. These voters, by double-digit margins, are more likely to back assertive sanctions and measures by the United States towards Russia. And we all know that the war has caused gas prices to rise sharply. But did you know that in developing countries like Egypt, which depend heavily on wheat and grain exports from the Black Sea, there's been a bread crisis? It's become very difficult for people to buy, and yet it's a staple food for everyone in these nations. So understanding Ukraine's geography allows us to explain this, because Ukraine is rich in one of the most fertile types of soil in the world, called Chernozem. This, along with its relatively flat terrain and location on the Black Sea, has allowed it to become one of the leading exporters of wheat in the world. But the Russian invasion has halted production of this wheat, as well as exports from key Black Sea ports such as Mariupol and Odessa, which are now destroyed from the war. So as consumers, geographic knowledge allows us to better understand where our goods come from, enabling us to make more informed purchases. Now, let's go back in time a bit. Most geographers agree that had we been better educated about Southeast Asia and Vietnam, we would have likely taken a different course of action during the Vietnam War, which basically means we probably would have pulled out earlier. I'm sure some of you here are familiar with the name Robert McNamara. He was the Secretary of Defense during the time of the war, and in his 1995 memoir, he would go on to list several major causes for disaster. Most notably, and I quote, "our profound ignorance of the history, culture, and politics of the people of the area. We underestimated the power of nationalism to motivate people. Interestingly enough, just last week, US intelligence officials were questioned for misjudging the governments of Ukraine and Afghanistan, as some believed that Ukraine would fall to Russia in a matter of weeks, and that the US-backed government in Afghanistan could last for months. We completely misjudged the geopolitics of the situation in Vietnam, and we continue to do so in many parts of the world today. Consider how costly not knowing more about a place is. Consider the amount of money spent and the number of lives lost. But the applications of geography extend far beyond the realm of geopolitics and are also applicable to things like global health. Geography has been crucial in understanding the COVID-19 pandemic. And with geography, we can explain almost every aspect of it, from the spread of the disease to the vaccine distribution or the worldwide economic effects. For example, why did Iran, out of all the countries in the world, have a large outbreak at the beginning of the pandemic? There's many factors, but we can actually trace this back to a single city, the site of Iran's first case. This city is called Qom, and Qom isn't the largest city in Iran, nor is it the most densely populated. But Qom is important because it's a major pilgrimage site for Shias, and introduction of COVID to the Middle East happened to coincide with Nowruz, the Iranian New Year. So increased travel to this city allowed the virus to spread quickly and to all parts of Iran. And understanding what creates hotspots like these is crucial for saving lives. This example, in particular, illustrates why religious and political authorities need to work closer together during times of pandemic. It's really a paradox that in a time where global events shape our lives more than ever, we are the least educated in geography. You see, geography isn't simply this rote memorization of capitals or places on a map, as much as I may find that entertaining. Geography is about making global connections, piecing together different disciplines and knowledge about places, so that we can better understand the events that take place in our world to make more informed decisions. Prominent geographer Arm de Blay put it simply, geography is synthesis. Geography's ability to connect the seemingly different is crucial for one of the greatest challenges of the 21st century, climate change. Now, we all know about climate change, but why are there still so many people who refuse to believe it? Or maybe even worse, not do anything about it? Now, I think there's lots of reasons, but a lot of this has to do with a lack of basic geographic knowledge. It's really hard to grasp the danger our planet is in when we don't know a lot about it in the first place. Our world is shaped by a web of intricate processes, like atmospheric phenomena, or oceanic circulation. And we really need to get to know how our planet works if we want to understand the challenges it faces, as well as the possible solutions. And geography opens up our eyes to the circumstances of places unfamiliar to us. And in learning about the places that are already grappling with the worst effects of climate change, we become more motivated to ensure that the same doesn't happen to us. Knowing about disasters like the drying up of the Aral Sea in Central Asia or the disappearance of glaciers in Bolivia is essential if we want to avoid similar mistakes in the future. In the end, geography allows us to be better global citizens. We need classes specifically dedicated to geography, not classes where a focus is on things like memorization or world capitals, but classes where students are taught how to connect the dots and make sense out of our complicated world so that they too can make informed decisions. And in universities where geography majors are all but a thing of the past, They should at least require students to take a couple basic classes in physical and human geography. But geography isn't just about saving the world from nuclear disaster or fighting climate change, because it also connects us as humans. Geographic knowledge can enrich our personal lives and our relationships, making us better people. Because when we learn about places, we also learn about the people there. So geography lends itself to cultural understanding. The more we learn about others, the more open-minded we become. And perhaps, if we were more knowledgeable and appreciative about other cultures, we would be less inclined to create conflict with those different from us. Thank you.